Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, I'm using my tool and cutter grinder to restore a parting off tool which had got damaged on the corner. The parting off tool is a high speed steel one, and the part of the tool got chipped away when I was parting some steel. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. This is my tool and cutter grinder. One of the first videos I did for YouTube was how to make the tool and cutter grinder. There's a series of, I think, about five videos on how to make this tool and cutter grinder. I've taken off the guard that was on here because the wheel is getting smaller and the guard protrudes over the wheel, so it makes it a bit more awkward to cut use the front of the wheel. This tool and cutter grinder has a table that can lift up and down, set to the angle you need. It moves left and right. It has a pivot point there and the angle round here that you're setting the tool to. And I made this attachment to fit on so you could just move the table by hand rather than having to push it. Get a bit more control on this, you can move it a little bit or you can move it a lot. So the first thing I've done is set the table, so this is not flat, the table, it's leaning back, and what we want to sharpen is this parting off tool, high speed steel, where I've broken the corner off so it's completely useless at the moment. You can see on the corner of the tool, it's broken off. Let me, so you can see easier there, or just chipped the corner off. And if you look at the top, you can see it's, instead of being square, it's diagonal. So I need to grind quite a bit off this to restore that cutting face. Now this is already machined on the parting off tool, the angle, so I've just reset it up at that. So what I want to do is take maybe a millimetre off the face to restore the edge, and at the same time, instead of grinding the edge square, I'll just turn it a couple of degrees so that this edge here is a little bit further out and the part will break off on the right hand side of the tool, giving me a clean finish on the part that's been parted off. If I grind it square, it could leave flash on either side of the part, but by grinding it at an angle, the one side should cut through first, giving me a clean finish on one side. So first of all, what I need to do now is give me something to rest on, because obviously I could put that anywhere on the tool, so I need something to rest up against and hold firm so that I can get a repeated cut. This is the standard part that comes with the machine. You have to make this up, you just get the steel and the screws and you make all the parts that come with the cutter grinder. So that rotates on there. Under here, there's the zero position, and each side I've marked up so I can see it easier. There's a pin that sticks out here, that locates in the hole on the table, and this will move to whatever angle you want. As you turn this, if you're using the block here, as you turn this, it will feed it in and out, but I'm not using that at the moment because I want to grind the tool in the holder so I know it's the right angles to the tool holder. This tool is tapered, so the bottom is narrower than the top, and it's held with this wedge at the top here. The wedge holds it into the tool holder. So all the grinding I'm going to do, I want to do in the tool holder, so I know the angles are right when it's actually put into the lathe. I'll replace that and I'll set that to about 2 degrees off square. Let's just get my locking pin. Locking pin goes through there and a little nut goes underneath. Just tip the table up because it's easier to put on from behind. So once the locking pin's in, I'll set this at about a degree and a half. It should do 1.5 degrees, so that the so when I rest the tool up against his face, it's actually a degree and a half tilted. Okay, I've just set the table angle to 8 degrees, which is the angle of this slope on the front of the tool, which was already cut in by the manufacturer. So it's 8 degrees to the front of the wheel, and it's 1.5 degrees that way. You can see there the setting. I've just set it about 1.5 degrees off square for the parting off tool, so it gives me a 1.5 degree angle on the tip. Let's bring it into the wheel and see what it looks like. That looks okay. So when I'm parting off, the part that falls off the bar should be clear of any swarf, so I don't need to clean it up. Now this wheel just attached to the motor. The motor can go either way. So when the motor's travelling that way, it's putting the force down onto the table. So if the motor's travelling the other way, it's trying to lift the tool up. So always cut with the force going down, so it's pressing the tool down onto the table. And of course, whenever you're machining or grinding, always use some safety goggles. Just under the wheel, I have this little plastic lid with oil in. This catches some of the dust and grit. The oil makes it stick to the plastic and will hold it there. Obviously, you will get dust and grit around the wheel. It's not too bad with a single tool, but if I was doing a lot of grinding, I'd have the vacuum on to remove the dust or a mask. You can see on that tool face, it's following the original grinding. And you can see the corner at the top is still missing. So on the left-hand side, as you're looking at it, it's gone right to the top. On the right hand side at the top, it looks black, there's no material there. So I still need to grind some more off. And all I'm doing is holding it up against this fixture, which is set at the right angle, and moving it backwards and forwards. Still starting to get warm, you can see it's just starting to discolour. So I'll get some water, just cool it off. So now if you look at that, you can see the cutting edge goes right up to the top. It's square with the top, and I've taken out the chip that was in the top. And the next thing I want to do is just put a slight angle on the top here. It'll work without that. Depends on the material you cut in. Aluminium, that will go through aluminium quite easy. So So you could put a slight angle on. Let's try it on a bit of aluminium, see how it cuts as it is. I've just put the tool in the tool post. I'm setting the tool square to the chuck. Just lock the top. Just check the tool height. The quick way of doing that would be to use the rule between the tool, wind it in, and if it's on center, the rule should stand up vertical. So if I lower it slightly, you see now this rule is leaning out towards me. The top here, that would be square, it's coming out, so it's just below center. It's okay. I think that broke off because of the pressure on the tool tip and the aluminium bending. That tool works okay. Obviously on steel I'll need to slow it down and add a bit more lubricant to it. It has left a pip on there, which is what I wanted. So if I need to sharpen this again, and I've left the settings as they are, I can just put this onto the side, move it into the wheel, and just sharpen it. So I can put that back in my tools, ready for go. So that's how this little tool and cutter grinder works. In this block you can put other fittings in the end. I have got this fixture here for lay tools, and all you do, this goes into the end of the block, put your lay tool in either this side, that side, or across, and then you can move it in front of the wheel. This is useful if you want to make a screw cutting tip, so you can get the angle each side right. And you make all these as part of the kit. All the work was done on the lathe, even the milling on this block was done in the lathe. And you can hold other items in the end, like center drills, or and this handle here gives you a fine feed. Oh well, that's it for today. I hope that was useful. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.